sure about this concept. So I'm going to start right from the beginning. What exactly is an inner child? How does it relate to us? So the thing is that usually when a child is born, it is in a state of wholeness. It is in a state of completion, in harmony in life. Okay? And as the child begins to grow, as the developmental years, milestones happen, as education comes in, what happens is the child is now obviously taking inputs from the environment, from the parents, from schools, teachers, siblings, etc. So the child is constantly being bombarded with inputs. Now the mind, over a period of time, starts developing a critical filter, you can call it, of say, you know, of how it perceives things, of how it filters things. So there's judgment and duality kind of begins to shape up. Now the child begins to view the world in a way of good or bad, right or wrong. I am loved or I am not loved. Light, dark. So basically duality becomes the key and everything is being seen as one way or the other. And what happens is that when the child is faced with any sort of say conflict, say trauma, okay, whenever there is any sort of hostility, inattention, either advertently or inadvertently, where the child is unable to process emotions, where the child is unable to process thoughts around what's happening to him or her, a small part of the child freezes in shock in that moment. Okay, so think about it, that the child, like, so this is, happens to so many of us, right? When we are faced with some sort of trauma or challenge, we feel that, oh my God, I'm just frozen in time right now. So as a child is growing, as experiences are constantly coming in their place, when they are faced with such trauma, many a times the development of that part of the child, that experience, it just kind of freezes, okay? And this becomes the creation of the inner child. Okay, I've got a question here. Is this an inner child when I... Yes, absolutely. So if there is, if you have experienced some sort of trauma, some sort of, an accident, an experience which has been very traumatic, something which has made you feel very, very sad. Yes, it is very possible that, an inner child can be formed at that point of time. Having said this, it does not mean that every moment in life, any experience that's happening is causing some sort of inner child. That's exactly not what we are saying. What we are saying is that yes, certain emotions, thoughts, experiences, when the child is unable to process, does not know who to ask or is not getting the answers and has just kind of soaked it in and not been able to deal with it, the creation of an inner child is possible over there. Okay, now the other part of the child continues to grow. So the development process is continued by the remaining personality, so to speak. And this subsequently, of course, becomes a grown-up as an adult. The inner child, which was created with the trauma and the memory of it, stays inside the adult, like it is trapped, okay? And it tends to surface. It tends to get activated whenever the adult personality is faced with a trauma which is similar to that of the inner child. Okay, so whenever as an adult now I am suddenly facing something which triggers in me the same sort of fear or the same sort of negativity or helplessness or avoidance, that inner child resurfaces. And when that inner child resurfaces, it can have various ways, but some of the common ones that I'll share with you that I worked with many of my clients is, it can be very, very controlling, okay? It can feel it's not good enough, so it will try to make the adult make choices or behave in certain ways so that it can feel protected, it can feel safe. So the way the inner child becomes and starts behaving or makes the adult behave becomes a way as a survival mechanism, so to speak. Many a times we don't even realize that we have moved from a space of, say, balance or wholeness or trust or just being who we are into this negative space, lower frequency, a place of fear where the body is feeling anxiety or panic, or any shift which we can interpret as a negative emotion or a negative sensation in the body. Chances are that this feeling, this inner child has kind of gotten activated. Okay, so that is one part of it, which is very important to understand. Now, what are some of the symptoms, so to speak? I mean, you know, it's not symptoms, but characteristics. So, you know, that can help you identify when one of your inner children surface into the present moment. So I have a few more questions here. Give me a minute. Okay, sure. Yeah, so I am getting some questions which I am covering as we go along. So give me a few moments and we will definitely go through these. Okay. So like I was saying that, just put this chat on the side. Yeah. So symptoms or characteristics or behavioral traits, interpretations that will help you to kind of understand or to kind of identify when one of your inner children have, so to, you know, have kind of awakened. Okay. So some of the very generic ones I'll share with you. You tend to play a very, the role of a victim. Okay, feel very helpless, can tend to feel very insecure. So a situation has come or an experience has come, or you're meeting someone, or you have this really major presentation you have to make and you know you are very good at it. But then at the same time, you start getting these negative thoughts. Okay, for many people, it could be the need for validation from an external source. Okay, so it could be that as well. Again, I'm not saying that all of these together will be the identification of yours. You pick and choose and identify, does this happen to me sometime? Do I sometimes become kind of irrational, or does my behavior go away from how I normally do? And I feel this anxiety, or I feel this panic, or I feel this, this feeling of being overwhelmed in some way. Does this happen to me? And if it does, chances are high that maybe an inner child has surfaced and you can work your way through that inner child to calm it down, to settle it, to integrate it, so that you can make better choices and have better experiences in your relationship. Another thing, a very common one, easily getting triggered. Okay, something happens, whether or not it is directed at you, you can take it personally and get very, very triggered. Looking for negative things. So even if things are not completely going down, but there are like some sort of fluctuations in what's going on, look for the most negative thing that can happen. Tendency to constantly get stressed or worried all the time. So anything has happened, the first reaction is, oh my God, now what's going to happen? Okay, feeling of being left out, feeling of being, not wanted by people around you. So just some very generic characteristics, which I have worked with my clients. And therefore, I know that it would be easy for you to identify in some way or the other if you are experiencing something along those lines. Now, it is important to realize one thing, that we don't have this one single inner child that is there within us and he or she emerges every time. We have different variations, you know, that kind of surface depending on the situation. We can refer to it as multiple inner children who can surface in different kind of situations, different kind of experiences, depending on what space and emotion we are currently experiencing in the moment. Now, this is because the formation of these inner children can happen in different kind of situations as we are growing along. Okay, it could be something to do with mistrust, it could be abuse, it could be a child is often made to feel guilty when he or she is small. Sometimes it could be as simple as role modeling in a dysfunctional family, where I have seen my parents, my mother, my father, unable to process their emotions, unable to handle. And that's pretty much exactly what I try to, remodel into myself. So many, many things. Rejection is, again, a very, very common one that I've worked with, and I've read with so many people that I worked on inner child processes with. So it can be a multitude of reasons, and no one except me or you, like whoever it's happening to, needs to feel the magnitude of it. So it may seem really small to someone else, but the same thing could mean absolutely everything for one person. So it's not about two people having the same experience, or it's not about the level of mistrust. It's just what one person feels. And in that moment, if we are unable to process those emotions, process those thoughts, and actually be able to sail through those emotions, they get trapped in the body. And they do get trapped in the body. And that is why many a times when the inner child work we do, we feel the release of anxiety, of panic, of a whole lot of sensations in the body itself. Okay, so I'm just gonna, just share with you a few common, like classifying them. Okay, one can be, one very big type is like the abandonment, so to speak. Abandonment is a huge, huge one. Now, as an adult, if you have a tendency in your relationships, in your experiences, many a times even those who have children will notice that as they work with their children, as they deal with their children, their insecurities tend to come to surface a lot more. So every time you are seeing your child and you want a certain result or a certain experience, and then you notice you get into some sort of a tangent or you start behaving very irrationally, it is an inner child who's trying to protect the adult you and is reflecting that behavior onto that child as well. Okay, so I was talking about abandonment. So now abandonment, the abandonment wound is more like constantly feeling left out. So you could be in a group, your friends may love you, your family may love you, but the child, but this adult would often feel in their in different experiences that they are not included. They have fears of being left out, left alone, can always not like to be by themselves, so will always look for company. So if they know that they are going to be alone, they will try to act, just maximize that day with things that they can do. They will call up people. They just hate being alone, just do not like to be alone. They can also be very, very emotionally dependent on other people. And they attract people also in their life space who are very emotionally dependent. And this can be a really difficult situation for the relationship, right? So many a times this abandonment wound shows up whenever there is something happening where you kind of feel that the other person is not giving you enough attention, or the other person has not made you the center of focus. This abandonment wound tends to get uncovered, and this inner child kind of pops up into your space. Okay, this is one category. Like I said, there are tons. For some, it can be related to feeling very, very guilty. So constantly feeling sorry or bad. Don't like to ask people for things or for support. Okay, so that's again another kind of an inner child who can keep coming up and making you feel more and more guilt. Sometimes another kind of way in this can be uses guilt to manipulate people into behaving certain ways with them. Okay, and because that's the vibration, think about it, it's really important. And I've always talked about emotion being your interpretation of the frequency that you are vibrating at. So when we are emotionally experiencing these negative kind of feelings, our frequency is then kind of radiating the same kind of vibrations, and we unfold into our lives, we bring into our lives, like we say, law of attraction, we manifest into our lives experiences, people, situations that further highlight the same wounds in our space. Okay, so when I have a constant feeling of being guilty, I will attract a partner or a friend or a sibling or someone in my space, a boss, who will make me feel guilty, who will trigger me and constantly make me feel like that. If I am constantly, I have this abandonment wound where I felt that I'm not loved as a child or I was not given attention, I will attract people in my life who will make me feel that I am not good enough for them. They will make me feel that I have to crave for their attention. Okay, so whatever we are feeling, it will keep showing up in our life. So that's a great way to identify if you are, you know, experiencing this in your relationships, if you are experiencing these kind of negative wounds in your own emotional life, in different spaces of your life, whether it's work, whether it's personally and things like that. Another big one is the trust one. Okay, so the trust one is that constantly in fear, cannot trust anyone else. Also, at times, doesn't trust their own self, so needs validation. So it's a very tricky space. Sometimes it will be that it is only about me, and yet I go into this very deep, dark place where I need validation, but I cannot trust another person. So that can be very, very hard for people when it comes. When you have this trust wound exposed, many a times you do not feel safe, you do not feel secure with anyone. You tend to attract people who again make you feel insecure in the relationship. So can be threatening to leave, can be threatening to end the relationship from time to time. And this keeps getting triggered into the relationship. So that's the trust one. Another one which I'd like to talk about before we move into the next steps and things is a very common one, which is being neglected. Okay, so neglected is so as adults, they struggle to forgive, to let things go. They can have very, very low self-worth, anger issues, okay? They find it extremely hard to express themselves. So there's this tendency to just suppress emotions inside, just keep it inside. And they feel very, very, the right word would be kind of vulnerable, okay? So there's this tendency to constantly feel vulnerable. Okay, and then this vulnerability kind of explodes in anger. So they get stuck in this kind of a pattern, of a rhythm. Now, the only reason I'm sharing all this is with you is so that you are able to identify for yourself, do you go through certain experiences? Do you go through phases where you could be absolutely fine, having a great day, and one email, one text, one picture on Insta of someone that you see can just instantly flood you with either negative emotions and suddenly make you out of balance? If that is the case, then it's not about just saying, oh, okay, I had a bad moment. It's not a coincidence. It is an indication of your emotions, of your body, that you need some work that you need to do here. And I will share with you some very, very simple processes that you can start right away, that you can start working with. Okay. So the first step is, let's kind of bring this into as we move into the process. The first step is to identify the appearance of your inner child. What do you do when you become aware of the negative emotion? Because sometimes our thoughts go unnoticed, okay? Because we spend so much time up here that many a times our thoughts go unnoticed. We feel that's the way it is. That's the way we think. That's the way I am. But the body does not lie, okay? So first step is tune in with the body. Whenever you are feeling any sort of negativity, tremble, anger, fear, anxiety, palpitation, absolutely anything in the body which kind of pops up, okay, or like we say, I have a lot of stress in my body, anything that you experience in the body, that is a sign for you to work with those emotions and not just push it aside under the carpet and say, okay, you know, I'll deal with it another day. So the first thing to deal with it, if you experience any kind of anxiety, any kind of panic, any kind of physical or emotional symptoms, is to say, I accept this is happening to me right now. Okay, and that is a huge relief. The minute you can say to yourself that I am feeling this and I accept this feeling, a lot of resistance and fight stops right there. That's the first part to start with. And when you accept it, you just simply can say something like this to yourself. It is okay for me to feel this way. I have compassion for my inner child. Just a generic statement I said here. You can create it the way you would like to for yourself. Okay, so you can change it in any which way that you would. So now that we have a broad understanding, I'm just going to go over the questions once in case I've missed anything. And then I'm going to start the process. We'll do a 4-5-step process where we will actually work with an inner child right now. So give me just a moment. Okay, I have. Okay, thank you. Need to get. Okay, no worries. Perfect. So I think I've got a thumbs up that I have managed to answer whatever it is. Great. So anybody else, if you have a question, feel free to post it. And then let's begin with our process. So for the process, it would be really nice if you would like to follow through it with your eyes closed. If you are not keen to get into an experiential space, you can even write down the process and do it later. But it would be a good idea to go through it right now as I kind of guide you with it. Okay, so our step number one, I already said, is to identify. So even if you want to work through it right now with me and then you want to continue with it later on your own, the first thing I would tell you is to try and identify one of your triggers right now and give it a number for your own self. You don't have to share it with anybody. So think of any of your triggers that kind of take you off balance. Something that brings a lot of fear in your space, something that brings you anxiety. So it could be absolutely anything. Bring that into your awareness right now and hold that thought with the intention to heal that inner child today. So I'm going to give you just a moment to bring that into your awareness. And once you have that, just close your eyes and just take a nice deep breath if you like to, you know, go along with it in the meditative experiential way today. Okay, so just giving it 1 minute to everyone. Just gonna put on some music here as that will help. Okay. Great. So let's start. My music is ready. So just sit in a very, very comfortable position. And you can close your eyes. And you can just bring into your mind this thought that triggers you, with the simple intention today to heal and a willingness to change that. And as you do that, and as you think about this trigger, this thought, this experience, it could be a trauma, it could be an argument, it could simply be a person who really, really triggers you and brings anxiety or fear in your space. Just begin to notice what's happening in the body as you bring these thoughts to your mind. And then just feel where all in the body are you experiencing any kind of sensations, triggers, stiffness, tension. Notice if your breath is changing in any way. Are you breathing more heavily, more rapidly? Is your breath short? And just keep going over that in this moment as though you are actually facing it. Now, as you become more in tune with this experience in the present moment, stay tuned completely with your body. Use your breath to tap into it. Just notice where all in the body are you feeling this most. Now, once you are aware that I tend to hold this anxiety perhaps in my chest, perhaps in my throat, many people feel it as a lump in their throat. Some people feel a lot of energy trapped in their solar plexus, in their stomach area. And once you are aware of this entire thing, once you are aware of where you are holding it, very gently take your awareness into your heart center. And from this heart center, let's set an intention, a willingness to shift, a willingness to change, and a willingness to heal. Just a simple intention. Today I am willing to look at things differently. Today I am willing to change the way I respond, react in such moments. And today I am choosing to heal from deep within. And the simple intention once again releases resistance. It allows your energy to know what you are looking for, and it tunes the energy to flow in a certain way. Now, from your heart, invite the energy, if you would like, of this higher power. Why do we do this? We can very well work with the inner child. There are many, many ways to work with the inner child without invoking the power of the creator, of the higher self, universe, cosmos, spiritual energy. It's possible. But when we allow this spiritual aspect to flow through us, we allow compassion, we allow grace, which literally melts patterns and conditioning of resistance, of suppressing. And so just from this heart space, with this willingness to heal today, invite the light of the Creator, invite the light, pure love, healing light of the cosmos, God, higher self, whatever name you give, just allow the light to flow through the top of your crown. And just feel this light coming into your space as it guides you, assists you in working and healing with your inner child. And just take a few moments as this energy, this shift, this vibration begins to flow. And some of you who are visual may be able to feel this flow through colors or sensations. Some may just experience some tingling in the body. And now that this light has completely flown through you, making it more easier, more comfortable for the inner child to come face to face with you, in your mind space, just take your awareness to a very, very comfortable room. And this room could be a room that you are aware of from your childhood. It could be a room of your imagination. It could be a place that you visit perhaps every day in your dreams and are not aware of. So just allow your mind to take you to this very, very safe space. This beautiful, comfortable room where you are completely at peace, at ease. This is your safe space. And there are no questions here. There are no judgments here. It's a pure thread of connection with your inner self, with your inner child. And so once you are in this space, in this room, I want you to invite your inner child that you need to integrate with today to come into the space. And your simple asking will allow this inner child in this very, very safe space to come to surface. And you can now just notice if you see yourself as a child, if a memory pops up, if you see this little boy or girl in front of you. And just begin to observe everything that you can about this little child. Noticing its body language, whether it feels fearful, whether it comes in smiling, jumping. Just notice everything that you can pick up. Stay tuned with the inner child. And now, go closer to this inner child. So you are sitting face to face. Perhaps even if the inner child looks really small, bend down on your knees so you can be at eye level with your inner child. Now look at her or him and thank her for coming here today. Thank him or her for talking with you, for being with you, to letting you know what it is that really, really makes her feel the way he or she feels. And take a few moments to do this. Don't hurry it at all. Your inner child has the answers, but is sometimes too scared to even speak. It's practiced being this way to keep you safe, as that's the only way it perhaps knew. So just like you would talk to a small child, let your inner child know it is safe for you to express what is making you fearful, what is making you anxious, what is making you scared. just wait for the answers, the expressions, the impulses. It is always unique for each one of us. Some of the inner children are so happy to have this moment of expression, and some are still extremely reserved, quiet, in a shell. Help them to come out of it. Ask the inner child, what makes you so scared? What are these limiting beliefs that you are still holding on to? Ask your inner child, why do you feel so low, so lonely, so scared? Go to the core of this, go to the center of this. For some, you may not receive any answer, don't give up. This inner child has been trapped perhaps for 10, 15, 20, 30, 40, 50 years, depending. It may not open up so easily. Be patient. Ask the inner child what will make you feel better. And sometimes you may get the answer in flashes. Sometimes you may have just an insight, a vision, a message, a sensation. Be open to receiving in all possible ways. Ask your inner child if he or she is ready to integrate back with you in the now, in the present, where you, as an adult, grown up, can take care of her and she will be or he will be safe. And you may notice some resistance from the inner child at this point, and that's okay. Don't force him or her. Let your inner child know that you are patiently waiting for the right time, for the right moment, when he or she is ready. Ask your inner child if you can hug him or her. And if your inner child allows you to hug him or her, give her a nice, nice hug filled with love. Let your inner child know that today you are choosing to send lots of light, lots of love, and lots of healing to him or her and to your own present self. And together you are choosing to raise the vibration as you come out of fear, as you come out of negativity, as you come out of anxiety, sadness. Notice if the inner child has softened further, and ask your inner child now if there are any people, any experiences that he or she wants to talk about, wants to forgive or not. And let him or her know it is absolutely safe to speak. No one is judging. And anything he or she says right now or feels right now is in complete acceptance and wholeness. And notice if that little inner child feels more secure, more comfortable. Tell the inner child that in the safe space, it is absolutely safe to return, to release, and to let go of those past energies that make her or him feel stuck and out of control. Let him or her know that, hear it from your own self. In your mind. And then just give him or her a few moments to release. You can ask them to breathe deeply and release it. You can even place your palms and show him or her to place their palms facing in front and just releasing what no longer serves them into the light which is flooding the safe space so it can transform it to love and light. Allow the experience to be as easy, soft, and let your inner child know that you are going to be taking all the steps that you need to take to constantly make him or her feel comfortable to be one with you at all times. And with this, give her one tight, give him one tight hug again. Letting him or her know that as you place your hands on your heart right now, you are sending it more love, more light, and healing today, tomorrow, and in every moment where you would notice he or she is triggered, alert, trying to control you, bringing up fear or anxiety in you. So let him or her know that they are being heard and they don't have to make it hard on themselves. And every time you experience that fear, that anxiety, you will be taking your palms on your heart if possible, or even holding your palms together if you are in a place where you cannot hold the heart. And through the power of your mind, through the healing energy coming from above, you will simply say, I am sending you light. I am sending you love. I am sending you healing in this moment, and together we are healing our life, our present, forever. And just do that a few times right now. Feel your inner child relaxing, beginning to accept and integrate back into the present moment, even though it may be so hard for him or her. For some, it may be really easy, and that's great. And just feel the light from above flowing, surrounding, vibrating, creating this beautiful, beautiful space of healing. Take both your palms, place them on the heart, connecting with your higher self, connecting with that creator's energy, connecting with this pure love light. And let's do that together. I am sending light, love, and healing to my inner child and to every cell of my body. I am sending light, love, and healing to my inner child and every cell of my body. Take one deep breath now. I am sending light, love, and healing to my inner child and every cell of my body. I am light, I am love, and I am healing my body, my present moment, my inner child, and my life in this moment. Take a deep breath. And just feel the entire energy flow through. Slowly you can move your hands away from the palm. You can gently rub both your palms together. And then place them on your face, your eyes, as you simply say, integrate in your mind three times. And then gently open your eyes into the present moment. Then just notice how you feel. I would say once again, like we had started, you had given a certain number on how you felt. Just check back with that. Just bring the thought to your mind right now and notice what that number is. Has it gone higher? Has it gone lower? For many people, it usually goes lower. If it has gone higher as well, there is nothing to worry. It simply means that somewhere there is a lot of resistance which is still in the way. But if you were to follow this process, and we did it, you know, because we were in a group, so it was very generic. But if you know your triggers, if you know those sensations, and if you can give it the time and patience to actually communicate with your inner child, and you do this every day for a period of, say, 21 days, okay? By the 7th, 8th day, you will start to feel a huge difference. But the most important thing is step one, which is having the awareness. Because when we stay in the mind, we sometimes do not pay attention to what the body is feeling. And the body is always in the present moment. The body is not in the past or the future. When we are worrying, our mind goes into the future. The mind can ruminate, right? But the body is in the present moment. So tuning into the body, noticing where in the body you are feeling that anxiety, that stress, that tension, that palpitation, that pain. Everything is speaking to you and telling you something is amiss there. And if you can tune into that, and then you can just give it a number like we did together, get into that space through the breath, through the body, then go into your heart and connect with that spiritual energy, that higher self energy, that creator's light. allow yourself to be surrounded by it, it just takes a lot of pressure away of you doing things yourself. And once that energy is there with you, as you tune into it, you will notice such beautiful impulses, directions, certain memories may flash, which you were not aware of, certain thoughts may come up, okay? So a whole lot of holistic way to kind of navigate through these feelings comes into your space. So yeah, that's pretty much how, it's one of my favorite ways. There are many, many ways of working with with the inner child. But this has always gotten some great results for my clients as well as for myself personally. So I thought I would share that with you today. So I hope you connected with it. I hope something which is of value to you and you would like to, work with it as we go along. If you have any questions, please feel free to share it here. If something you need to know more in detail, feel free and I'll be happy to share it as we go along. So I'm just gonna go through the chat box and see if we have some questions here. Okay, thank you very much, Suzanne. I hope it helped you. Thank you, Kiran. Thank you very much. Yes, you can do this with different kind of inner children. Someone sent a personal question. You can work with across emotions. Doesn't have to be with fear or anxiety. That's right. It could be any feeling you have. And that's why I said tune into what it is tune into whatever it is that you're feeling. Wonderful. Is there any, thank you, Priya. So happy to see you here. Thank you so much. And I'm seeing some new messages and new people. Wonderful to have you here. Excellent. Okay, thanks a lot. Thank you very much, Ms. Anur. Thank you, Anya. Yes, I know. It can be very emotional. I know exactly what you mean. And the more you feel the emotions and don't hide away from it, the better it is. Releasing is the key, right? So that's what it is. Thank you so much, Sakshi. Thank you, Miss Sumati Sahani. It is so awesome to see you here. It's my pleasure. And thank you, Farooq. Great. Thank you all. And wonderful, Dominic. I'm so happy that, your patience and the fact that you were able to be here. Like I say, it's never a coincidence, right? No, nothing is a coincidence. It's all alignment. So if you waited and you're here, it was for a reason. So I really, really appreciate that you stayed on. And your concern, I will share with the team and we'll make sure that doesn't happen again. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much, Bharti. Yeah,
thank
appreciate
you.
It. Thanks.
Yeah. Yes, Hannah, you had a question. If you're trying to deal with, will you need to work with that? It would always be definitely better.
Thank
because
you, see,
inner children are not, formed over a day or a week, right? It's been over a long period of time. And sometimes it's pretty much like dealing with a small child. So if you've dealt with a child, Hannah, you would know sometimes it takes coaxing. Sometimes it takes a lot more patience. So yes, it would make sense to do that, to kind of work on a regular basis with them. And sometimes what will happen, and I'll share this with you, is that when you're working with one inner child, there are some that are formed because of the first one. So it's literally like if you see energy or feel it, you will feel like, they are collapsing like those Russian dolls. They just kind of collapse into it. So that also happens. So yeah, do work multiple times till you feel light. Okay. Thank you very much, Andrea. Very nice that you could join today. That's lovely. What if you didn't really feel the inner child? That's okay, Dominica. Not everyone sees. And even if you didn't feel, that's fine. It could be that there was resistance. It could be that the inner child, it will take some more time. But do the practice. Do the practice of these steps, even if you don't have so much time. And if you can do it in a shorter period of time, do the steps regularly. You will start to experience the inner child. Even if you don't see it or feel it, you will know its presence. Even if that is not happening in your practice, start with the awareness in the present moment when you get the symptoms, so to speak. So when you suddenly feel this raging anger or this palpitation or shortness of breath because someone said something, that's an inner child. Acknowledge it. When you acknowledge it, you can work through with it. Yeah, so because it's possible that over so many years, you've just kind of phased it out, and now it may take some time to, you know, reflect or show in front of you. Great. So that's what we have today. Thank you so much once again. We are here again online as well as offline now for consultations, for private sessions, if that's something that you're looking for. And of course, a lot more webinars and meditations coming up. So thanks again, everyone. Have a wonderful evening. And I look forward to seeing you all again. Thank you.